Yeah, hi. Could you start by introducing yourself, please?
Hi, I'm Jason Lai. I'm a second year oral maxillofacial radiology resident at UCLA. And I'm here at the Harvard Dental AI Symposium. It's been a very fruitful time. I've met Shannon in very fruitful conversations. I guess I've been working on an app, I guess, so to speak, that I've fully vibe coded with Claude Code. And it's a radiology portal for dentists to upload their scans and be able to access them on the cloud. This is my dad's scan. And so I've done this all, no programming knowledge at all. And you can go to the scan and actually view the scan. And so my goal is to have dentists be able to easily store their images on the cloud and then provide it to other providers. That's a big issue in, I think, dentistry. We have CDs and USB sticks that just get moved around rather than just, we have the cloud, it's 2025. And so, and with this app, you can also bring in a radiologist to read your CBCT scans if you'd like to. And so eventually I have hopes of, bringing this to market and hopefully connecting dental labs as well to it and having a marketplace with that. So it's easy, seamless movement of patient data that's fully HIPAA compliant. So it's been very exciting. I did it in 3 weeks.
Nice.
It's been fun.
Right. Yeah, so it would be interesting to hear like what inspired you to work on this app.
Yeah, so one of the inspirations for me is just seeing in the clinic that, like I said, people have USBs and disc and all of this and different viewers. And it's just like such a nightmare for patients and providers to have to deal with this. And I think that it really diminishes patient care because it takes so long just to transfer files where now we can't actually do patient healthcare rather than just easy, seamless uploading of data and reading the data and with a viewer on top of that. And so that inspired me, as well as hopefully this will help clinicians find radiologists, oral radiologists, to help them read CBCT scans as well, because that's our expertise, so we can help clinicians too. So yeah.
Great. And what would be some of your advice or tips for someone looking into vibe coding a similar app?
I highly recommend Claude Code. I've used all of the coding, or all of like the AI, Perplexity, Gemini, Claude, ChatGPT. And a year ago, I would have said, it's very difficult. There's no way I would have been able to do this, but it's such an exponential growth, especially with coding, that either Cursor, which agentically codes, or Claude Code, it's definitely more of a learning curve, but once you get the hang of it and you use like the MCP, the model context protocols and the Claude skills that they have and these agents, once you get your grasp around that, I think it's very powerful. Prompting is very key, and Claude provides there's a lot of open source prompting tools you can get with Claude Code. So yeah.
Right. And how does Claude Code differ from traditional Claude?
Claude Code runs within your terminal or VS Code, but with traditional Claude or ChatGPT, it will write your code, but it'll just be on like the internet. So now I have to copy that into my like program, see if it works. And if it doesn't work, I have to send whatever bug, whatever error back to the internet, get the fix, put it back in. It's very time consuming, which is what I was doing initially. But Claude Code it can just see all of the errors. It can run the code within your terminal, see the errors, automatically correct, and like done. So there's no human just like copy paste, very inefficient. Now it's like extremely efficient.
So this process could be done autonomously.
Yeah.
So it runs, it encounters some error, and then it debugs itself.
Exactly. Yeah. And it connects to all the different APIs that I need, like Supabase, Google Cloud API, and without me even touching it. All it needs me to do is make an account, and then it does the rest. And it's very impressive.
Right. In terms of the cost, how much did it cost you to code this in 3 weeks?
For me, mostly time. I was using the $20 a month program with Claude, and now I'm on the max $100 a month plan, but that's plenty for what I've done. And yeah, so $100 a month versus thousands of dollars. And however, I mean, who knows how long, 6 months to actually get something up and running, going back and forth with the software developer, rather than me knowing exactly what I want and telling my personal Cloud Code agent what to do. It's 3 weeks has been, and mostly 2 weeks, I would say. So, yeah.
Right. And also, could you also talk about your educational background?
So I studied health science at Northeastern here in Boston, and then went to dental school at UCLA, and now at UCLA for radiology. But I have no formal technical, like any coding experience, a little Python, but like just like intro class. And so this really opens a lot of opportunities for people like me who have ideas but haven't been able to act on them until like these agents came out. So it's a very exciting time.
Right. So we could say that you have some knowledge of Python as you vibe-code it?
Very minimal, I would say. I did replits, like 100 days of code, and I got through like 30 days. So like I know what things look like, but I truly, like I couldn't fix any bugs with this. So yeah.
Right. So someone without any prior coding experience could try out the vibe coding and
yeah, definitely. Definitely. Just watch a few videos on the tools you need and the best way to prompt. It's all about prompting. Everyone talks about it, but prompt engineering is truly the best way to get the best results, out of these tools.
Right. Would you be open to maybe connecting with your audience on social?
Sure. Yeah. My Instagram is JLAI08. And my LinkedIn, I don't even know my LinkedIn. What is it?
Yeah. Yeah. We could share the link.
We could share the link.
Description.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. I mean, thanks for sharing your journey. And are you planning on creating a startup based on this?
I would like to. I would love if there's any machine learning engineers out there. I would need some help with, some potentially pipelines, artificial intelligence pipelines I have in mind. But yeah, so if anyone's out there, I'd love some help.
Yeah, thanks for sharing.
Cool.